Places like Gleaners have been seeing a lot of fresh fruit and vegetables come in, which isn't a bad problem to have.
This particular situation, using this in a trade issue, I think is the first time that we've seen anything like this happen through the USDA.
Carrots, milk, and meat are some of the items pouring into food banks across the country, in part thanks to the ongoing trade war.
Between the commodity food that we normally get and the trade mitigation, it's expected to double at least for most food banks throughout the country for fiscal years 19 and 20.
The surplus of food is coming from American farmers who can't sell to Chinese markets. Because China isn't purchasing the products, the government is stepping in, buying and distributing the surplus to food banks. Currently, 59 million pounds of food is coming right here to central Indiana, according to Feeding Indiana's Hungry. The surplus of food can come with challenges.
A lot of food banks have difficulty, this one included, with having enough storage space for freezer and refrigerators.
Weicker Bryant says they don't mind if the government provides a solution for storing it and Hoosiers are fed.
With the food is coming about $2,000 per truckload for them to store and distribute the food.
Midwest has seen a surplus of produce coming in too. They're up 30%. Their executive director, John Whitaker, can't tell if it's because of the trade war or new strategies to bring more food in.
We're getting more product because we're being more intentional about going after that product. Some of it might be due because of the deficit we have with some of the trade.
Weicker Bryant expects to see the same amount of food from the USDA come in through 2020. Aaron Cantrell, CBS 4 News.